Sharks are normally found in coastal waters in the summertime. Many species of sharks give birth in shallow coastal bays. Many of these coastal bays are used as their nurseries. So this is not unusual to see sharks in coastal waters during the summertime. The reason that we have shark attacks, in most cases, is the shark has mistaken a human for its natural prey. Think of it this way. You're kicking in the water like this, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. You're just having fun, having a good time. The shark is not moving into that area because it's attracted by you, the person. It's attracted by the splashing, but also it'll see that white flash in the water, which it's confusing for a wounded prey item like a wounded bait fish. Some examples on how this can happen is if a person happens to go in swimming where the water is turbid or murky, or at times of the day like sunrise or sunset, when the visibility is poor, think of the bottom of your hand or the bottom of your foot. That's a white contrast in the water, and the shark may become confused and thinks that flashing in the water is its natural prey when it actually it's the bottom of a person's foot. That's why we see a lot of bites that occur in the calf or in the thigh, because that is the area that's adjacent to your foot flashing in the water. Along those same lines are people that wear jewelry, like ankle bracelets. And if you think about fishermen, when fishermen use artificial lures, what do they normally use? Stuff that flashes in the water. Well, that flashing in the water is designed to replicate a wounded fish. Well, it's the same sort of thought. The flashing on that ankle bracelet could attract a shark, again, confusing its natural prey with the human that's in there kicking in the water. Generally, you know, we recommend to the public when they do go in swimming to follow some certain safety precautions, which are designed to reduce the likelihood of having an encounter with a shark. The first thing that we would want to recommend to people is if there is someone fishing in that area, we generally would want to avoid swimming in that particular area. The reason why is that, you know, the person fishing may not be fishing for sharks. Whatever they're happen to be fishing for example, striped bass or bluefish, they may be using bait, but that bait may also attract a shark and bring it into the area where people are swimming. Also, if you see schools of bait fish in the water, even regardless if no one is fishing or not, try to tend to avoid swimming in those areas because that school of bait fish may be attracting a shark into the area. Another thing would be to swim in groups. Many individuals in the water together, splashing, making a lot of noise, the shark generally isn't going to go to that particular area. But one individual out by itself, splashing in the water, may represent to the shark a single fish out by itself that's wounded or injured, which could represent its potential prey. Also, try to avoid swimming in areas where a sandbar may cause a deep cut or channel next to the beach, because a shark sometimes uses those deep cuts to move in and out of the shallow water and then back offshore again. So swimming in that area may increase the likelihood of having an encounter with a shark. It's important to emphasize that although the likelihood of sharks and humans coming into contact with each other is increased in the summertime, shark attacks are extremely rare when you consider everything else that can happen to an individual when they go swimming. I mean, think for example, the number of people that drown every year that are caught in rip currents. That number far exceeds the number of people that are attacked by sharks. Also think even things like getting stung by jellyfish, stepping on a stingray. Those figures greatly outnumber the number of people that are attacked by sharks every year. In fact, you have a better chance of getting in a car accident and being injured on your way to the beach than you do actually when you get to the beach and go in swimming. NOAA Fisheries is responsible for the sustainable harvest of shark populations. For example, if we have a particular species that we are scheduled to begin a stock assessment on, we will begin gathering biological information such as growth, reproduction. We'll begin the process of doing research on those particular items of their life history, so this information can be used in the assessment process. We also have ongoing surveys of their abundance, and then we'll begin gathering those bits and pieces of information to track their abundance through time, so that information can be used in the stock assessment.